This is the Catholic Daily Mass Readings and Reflections for Friday of the 8th week in Ordinary Season. Today's first reading is from Sirach chapter 44 verses 1 and 9 to 13. And the Gospel reading is from Mark chapter 11 verses 11 to 25. Thanks for joining today's Mass Readings and Reflections. If you are new to this channel, please consider subscribing to this channel. First reading. A reading from the book of Sirach, chapter 44, verses 1 and 9 to 13. Let us now praise famous men and our fathers in their generations. And there are some who have no memorial, who have perished as though they had not lived. They have become as though they have not been born, and so have their children after them. But these were men of mercy, whose righteous deeds have not been forgotten. Their prosperity will remain with their descendants, and their inheritance to their children's children. Their descendants stand by the covenants, their children also for their sake. Their posterity will continue forever, and their glory will not be blotted. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Responsorial Psalm. Your response. The Lord takes delight in His people. Sing to the Lord a new song, O praise in the assembly of the faithful. Let Israel be glad in their Maker. Let the children of Zion rejoice in their King. Your response. The Lord takes delight in His people. Let them praise His name in the festive dance. Let them sing praise to Him with timbrel and harp. For the Lord loves His people, and He adorns the lowly with victory. Your response. The Lord takes delight in His people. Let the faithful exult in glory. Let them sing for joy upon their couches. Let the high praises of God be in their throats. This is the glory of all His faithful. Your response. The Lord takes delight in His people. Gospel acclamation. Alleluia, Alleluia. I chose you from the world to go and bear fruit that will last, says the Lord. Alleluia, Alleluia. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark, chapter 11, verses 11 to 25. As he entered Jerusalem and went into the temple, and when he had looked round at everything, as it was already late, he went out to Bethany with the 12. On the following day, when they came from Bethany, he was hungry. And seeing in the distance a fig tree in leaf, he went to see if he could find anything on it. When he came to it, he found nothing but leaves, for it was not the season for figs. And he said to it, "May no one ever eat fruit from you again." And his disciples heard it. And they came to Jerusalem, and he entered the temple, and began to drive out those who sold and those who bought in the temple. And he overturned the tables of the money changers and the seats of those who sold pigeons, and he would not allow anyone to carry anything through the temple. And he taught and said to them, "Is it not written, 'My house shall be called a house of prayer for all the nations'? But you have made it a den of robbers." And the chief priests and the scribes heard it and sought a way to destroy him, for they feared him, because all the multitude was astonished at his teaching. And when evening came, they went out to the city. As they passed by in the morning, they saw the fig tree withered away to its roots. And Peter remembered and said to him, "Master, look, the fig tree which you cursed has withered." And Jesus answered, "Have faith in God. Truly I say to you, whoever says to this mountain, 'Be taken up and cast into the sea,' and does not doubt in his heart, but believes that what he says will come to pass, it will be done for him. Therefore I tell you, whatever you ask in prayer, believe that you will receive it, and you will. And whenever you stand praying, forgive. If you have anything against anyone, so that your Father also, who is in heaven, may forgive your trespasses. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Dear brothers and sisters, Jesus' gesture of disrupting the temple commerce is a prophetic warning of the far greater disruption that he foretells. As the following episode will show, it also prepares the way for understanding the new and a greater temple of the new covenant. The temple not made with hands, that is his own body. Thus, Jesus' cleansing of the temple also has significance for the church, the body of Christ. Christians today can ask, are we consumed with the zeal for God's house that motivated Jesus? If we consider the temple of our own parish or community, do we find it polluted with what does not belong there? With a self-serving leadership, factions, gossip, sexual immorality, commercialization, or lack of charity toward those outside one's socio-ethnic group? Are we bringing the church into the world or world into the church? Surely, the stewards of the ancient temple are not the only ones guilty of compromising the holiness of God's house. The book of Revelation depicts Christ coming to judge local churches, threatening to remove the lampstand of those who do not repent and bear good fruit. The point is not for us to judge others, which would only compound the problem, but to repent for our own part, to weep and mourn. As Prophet Joel says, put on sackcloth and lament, O priest, wail, O ministers of the altar, go in past the night in sackcloth, O ministers of God, because cereal offering and drink offering are withheld from the house of your God. Sanctify a fast, call a solemn assembly, gather the elders and all the inhabitants of the land to the house of the Lord your God, and cry to the Lord, interceding that God's loving temple would be restored to holiness. On another level, St. Paul affirms that not only the church, but also our individual bodies are temples of the Holy Spirit. In his first letter to the Corinthians chapter 6 verses 19 to 20 says, do you not know that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit within you, which you have from God? You are not your own. You were bought with a price. So glorify God in your body. If we consider our own heart, is it sometimes more like a marketplace than a temple? Is it cluttered with worldly pursuits, busyness, lust, or selfish preoccupations? If so, we can pray that Jesus would cleanse this temple too and make it a house of prayer.